Alright, hello everyone. In this lecture, I'll talk you through getting an airfoil into SolidWorks, and then in the subsequent lectures, I'll teach you how to make ribs and spars, and pretty much come up with the full airfoil. So today we'll go and make a horizontal stabilizer for a tail, and this will be a T-tail. And again, I'm just bringing in the airfoil geometry and show you some tools on how to do that. So the first thing you want to do is go to Google and type in airtools.com. Whoops. Actually, airfoiltools.com is the thing that you want. And in this website, you'll find NACA 4-digit numbers. Those are generally what you're going to want. As you can see here, there's a list. Depending on like your application, whether it's a wing, a horizontal stabilizer, vertical empennage, you're going to want to pick a thick airfoil or a thin airfoil. The thicker helps with stability. So for the horizontal stabilizer, we're going to go with the E168. And you can make a custom search for it up here in the search bar. This is a British airfoil. It's thicker, which helps with stability. And so we're searching for it, we'll pick it up. And here it will have the geometry. It's a symmetric airfoil, which is needed for a tail, whereas a wing doesn't need to be symmetric. And what you could actually do is download the DAP file, which is basically a collection of points that specifies the geometry of the airfoil. And you're going to want to copy and paste this into a notepad. Alright, so I'm going to open up Notepad, paste it in there, whoops, save this file. You can delete this top line. What you're going to want to save it as is whatever the airfoil name is. Make sure you save it in a location that you know. So for me, I'm going to go into Jobs. And I'll give it a file name as E168. Alright. So now that we got that, we can open up Excel. It's kind of a process to get this. Eventually we're going to get it into SolidWorks, these points. But it needs to be in just the right format before we do that. So we're going to open up Excel. Notice that if I just copy and paste here, it's not going to work. It won't be delimited by columns. This is all in one column, so you can't really export that. So I'm going to just Control Z that real quick. So you're going to want to insert. You want to insert that text file. Trying to find that real quick. Insert. There you go. Data from text. You're going to find your text file. So for me, I should probably make a shortcut for this, which will help. Going to so just again, we're finding that text file. I'm gonna bring this over and make a shortcut. So we're gonna be referencing this a lot. There it is. We're going to want this file. And it's going to ask us how do we want this separated. And we're going to want it space delimited. So here you got delimited. we want space. So there it separates it into two columns. You can see with the lines. Perfect. Sure, finish. Paste it right there. That's good. So now we got two columns with the airfoil. I'm going to go ahead and delete this first one, this first row, and delete this first column. Whoops. Did not delete it there. Okay. So this is normalized to 1, and that's the width. So what you're going to need to do is figure out how wide you want your airfoil. And your airfoil is going to have a taper on it. So for instance, starting at the middle of the tail, the wing's going to be a bit larger than at the end of the tail. So for our first airfoil, we're going to start with the largest. And for me, I came up with 19 inches. So I'm going to do multiply everything here by 19. And the same goes for the second column as well. And then what you could do is just drag that down. So now you actually have your points of your airfoil that's not normalized. But unfortunately, the text file that you need to export to SolidWorks needs to just be two columns. So there's another step that we got to do. We're going to want to copy all these values. And then we're going to want to paste values. So if we go to home, paste values, and it's important because if you just hit Control C, Control V, it carries the formula with it, and then if you delete these two columns, which we're then going to do, then it doesn't carry over those values because it's specified by a formula. So you need to do that procedure. And then the third thing is we need our Z points. The Z points are all going to be zero. This is a two-dimensional airfoil that we're then going to extrude in SolidWorks. So making all those zeros, and lastly, we're going to want to save this as two file formats. The first file formats first one's going to just be, you want to save the Excel file just because it's useful. So E168, I'm just going to say 19 so I know for later. So we save it as Excel workbook. Good. Lastly, we're going to want to save it as a text file for importing into SolidWorks. And it needs to be a tab delimited text. If there's other text files, those won't work. It needs to be tab delimited. So, again, it's different from the original mass normalized one here. So this is 19. And so we just got to remember that when we're bringing it into SolidWorks. Hit yes here. Okay, so we could even open it up and take a look. And this is what it looks like. It's tab delimited. It's got three columns, which is what Excel needs. Or I'm sorry, SolidWorks needs. So now we're on to the SolidWorks part. We're going to want to start a new part. And this procedure gets a little tricky. If SolidWorks wants to load. There it is. Alright, so you're going to want to go to File, Insert, curve through XYZ points, which we just made with our text file. Browse for that text file that we saved. So for us, it's going to be here. And you got to make sure you click this, otherwise you won't be able to find it. So there's that. And not sure why I'm getting this error message. Oh, I do know why. One thing you need to do is you need to close out, otherwise SolidWorks won't be able to open it. And I know this doesn't look like a text file, but after you save it, as long as this Excel file's up, it will not export to SolidWorks. So do you want to save your changes? No, because we already saved it. Let's try that again. Whoops. Alright, here we are. And up here, you'll see that, yes, it's the first point's 19, which is what we want the chord length to be. And everything's right on there, and you can even see the outline over here. So that's good. Except, let's see where the plane is. Yeah, that's good. So, here's the two-dimensional view. It looks very much like what we found here. So we got that geometry into SolidWorks. So next thing we're going to want to do is, this is the, I guess, middle of the horizontal stabilizer. We're going to want to import the end of the horizontal stabilizer. So we're going to have to do that same procedure. So again, we're going to open Excel. And then we're going to go to data from text. Going to import that text, U168. Get space in there. Finish. Paste it right there. Going to delete it here. Delete it here. And then the end of it will be 11 inches this time. So multiply everything by 11. Sorry to drag you through all this two times, but if you missed anything the first time, I guess this will be a good time to check. So again, we just copied it there. We're going to need to paste values here so the formulas don't transfer over. After we paste values, we're going to delete these four rows. We're going to add our zero row for the Z column for SolidWorks to read. Just double click on this check mark, it'll go all the way down, and then we're going to want to save that as a text tab delimited file. Make sure you know where that you saved that. And so here's the file type, tab delimited, E168. This is the 11 inch one. And again, it's always a good idea to save this as both formats, because you know, you may want to come back to this and just change the length to say something else, and then you have this Excel file already, so you don't need to redo the same process. You just need to multiply by a constant number, so that can be pretty helpful. So I'll just save it as Excel workbook in case I need to go back to it in the future. Alright, and then remember, you gotta X out. Alright, so now we want to insert that new curve. So, same process as before. We'll go up to make sure you're getting the text file. The 11 inch looks good. It's a bit smaller, just like we want. We're going to hit OK. So, right now these are curves. We need to make them sketches on planes. So the first sketch we're going to do is we're going to convert the entities. We're going to select this curve. And now we've got a sketch of that. Exit sketch. And then we got to put this airfoil on a plane that's further away to simulate the end of the horizontal stabilizer at a length of L over 2, since we're only doing half of the horizontal stabilizer. So if you go to Insert, Reference Geometry Plane, could actually reference this top front plane here. I've got the total length to be 56 inches. You can see that. So that's good. Now we're going to sketch on this plane. Convert entities. And boom, it shows up on this plane. We're going to want to get rid of this constraint that fixes it at the origin. And then we're going to want to shift and drag it. It's very important that you press shift. And then we're going to smart dimension this thing from this point to the origin. Make sure it's kind of like a horizontal dimension. We'll call it 19.7 inches. Or sorry. And I'll go to a better view for you. So right now it's good as far as like lengthwise. It's where we want it to be, but we got to get it to align. So we need this vertical dimension. I'm just going to set that to 0 so they're aligned. And boom. One other thing that we need is a line that connects these two points. And we're going to sketch that on this top plane here. We're going to go from this point straight to this point. And it should snap right to those points. And you can see that it's even got a coincident symbol here, which means it has snapped successfully. So we'll exit that sketch. We'll go to Features, Lofted Boss Base. And then it asks for sketches. So we could sketch one. Sketch 2, and then it's guided by Sketch 3. So if I delete this, well, I guess it still looks good, but it's nice to have this guide here to show where it wants the loft. So if hit OK, there it is. It's a lofted airfoil. It's half of the horizontal stabilizer. Obviously, you still need to put internals in there, ribs and spars, but it's a good start. Whoops. Yeah, I'm just messing around with it. And you can imagine your vertical empennage is going to look similar as well. So it's going to follow the same process. I want to show you how to give this a thickness. Right now it's just a surface, so let's make it a little bit thicker so that it's actually a viable, manufacturable airfoil. Alright, so what we're going to do next is go to, if you right-click up here, you can find surfaces, and then you click on it, and you go to surfaces, and you can hit offset surface, click the loft, but offset it just 0 inches, so pretty much we're just creating a surface that's over that loft, and we could even go in and hide this loft now. We'll hide it, and so this is the surface that we just created. So now we could go to thicken, and this isn't going to work, but I want to show you why it doesn't work. So if we thicken this, and we say 0.2 inches, it'll give us an error because the face filled right here, it runs into trouble trying to mesh these points together, so it can't do that with these end points. So what we have to do before we do that process is create a new plane. We'll reference the right plane. We'll offset it 19.5 inches. Well, no, how about 18.5? Sure, that'll work. So you see how that plane kind of transects here? And you could even create a plane if you really want along this like line. This isn't perfectly straight, but the plane is. But I just wanted to give you a general sense of how to design it. But this will work for our purposes right now. So plane 2 is created. We're gonna sketch on that plane, just make a big box pretty much. You don't really need to dimension it. We'll exit that sketch. We'll go to surfaces, planar surface, sketch 4. So we're making this a surface now. It looks pretty ugly. But now there's this awesome feature in SolidWorks called delete face. So we can select that. Whoops. Actually, maybe it's not delete face. It's trim surface is what the awesome feature is. Sorry about that. So we're going to select this. So notice how it says keep selections. And then this is our what we're trimming with. We'll hit OK. Well, that didn't work. We're going to delete that. I think I had those mixed up. Sorry about that. Redo it. So this is our trim tool. This is the thing we want to trim. And it says keep the selection. So it just got rid of that piece there. And then we're going to just right click this and go to hide. Alright. Looking ugly yet? Alright, so now we can thicken that surface like I was trying to do earlier. We'll thicken this 0.2 inches. And it works out. So we've got this now. It's got a thickness. Obviously, we have some cleanup to do back here. But the thing is, with the horizontal stabilizer, your rudder is going to be imported back here anyway. So don't even worry about this nastiness yet. The rudder and how we design that. I'm going to teach you some simplifications you could use. But ultimately, this is not a concern right now, so don't worry about it. But try your best.